the heels, sneakers, pumps, or lace up your boots. Representing all the women, salute. So ladies all across the world, listen up, we're looking for recruits. If you're with me, let me see your hands, stand up and salute. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, or lace up your boots. Representing all the women, salute. Let me hear you say. Ladies all across the world, listen up, we're looking for recruits. If you're women, let me see your hands, stand up and salute. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, or lace up your boots. Representing all the women, salute, salute. Let's headshot, salute. Let's headshot, salute. Let's headshot. Representing all the women, salute, salute.
We are everywhere, warriors, your country needs you. If you're ready, ladies, better keep steady.
A mission and we'll hit you with the truth.
Divas, queens, we don't need no man.
Salute, we are everywhere. Warriors, your country needs you. If you're ready, ladies, better keep steady, ready. Aim, show need ammunition on a mission and we'll hit you with the truth.
Representing all the women.
Salute, salute. It's who we are. We don't need no camouflage. It's the female and the world we're taking on.
If you're with me, women,
let me hear you say. Ladies all across the world, looking for recruits. If you're women, let me see your hands, stand up and salute. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, or lace up your boots. Representing all the women, salute, salute. Let's headshot, salute. Let's headshot, salute. Let's headshot. Representing all the women, salute, salute.
You think we're just pretty things? You couldn't be more.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome to this very special webinar, Why Smart Goals Don't Work, with myself, Shivani Gopal, founder and CEO of The Remarkable Woman. It is so lovely to be spending this hour with you and talking about something that I know all of us take a lot of pride in and have a lot of importance in life, and that is setting goals, right? We all set goals. We all want to achieve the goals. The problem is actually doing it. The problem is actually achieving that outcome. And that is exactly what we'll be focusing on today, plus a number of other things. I'm sure you're probably also wondering a little bit about who am I and why am I actually speaking with you today. So I'll take you through a little bit of an introduction of myself. As I said, I'm Shivani Gopal. I'm the founder and CEO of The Remarkable Woman. It is an organization that is all about accelerating the path towards equality. If we move to the next slide, I'll be happy to share a little bit about myself. So I am a startup entrepreneur. I founded two startups myself. One, of course, is The Remarkable Woman. Another one is a fintech called Upstreet. I've always driven by my strong sense of purpose, which is to be fearless in the pursuit of a greater tomorrow. And that is something that I have dug deep to find out. And by finding that out, I've been able to move through my career, whether it be my career in financial services, which is where my original pedigree really lies from a corporate or a training perspective. I spent over 15 years in financial services as a financial advisor, through to being a financial services executive, through to now founding The Remarkable Woman and through the organization coaching and mentoring thousands of women. I've also been asked to speak on women's issues when it comes to matters of politics, business, women's careers, leadership across many different media platforms, Channel 7 being one of them, Channel 9 being another, Sky Business News, Sky News, and a number of other media outlets. But to be honest, the thing that really drives me is really just spending that time with women and helping them achieve their goals and helping them be the best versions of themselves. And funnily enough, if you want to be the best version of yourself, you are more than likely not setting goals for yourself and wanting to achieve that. And so my hope today is that in our time together, I can help you get one step closer of realizing that goal of being the best version of yourself, because you deserve nothing less. So let's move on to the next slide. So a little bit more about us and who we are at The Remarkable Woman. As I mentioned, we are an organization that is all about accelerating the path towards equality for women and for the world. And we focus on empowering women in three key ways: personally, professionally, and financially. Why those three things? Because in my time as a financial advisor, in my time as a coach, as a mentor, as an executive, as a startup entrepreneur, I have realized that empowerment is like a house built on sand unless you really focus on those three pillars, those three foundations of growth. You can't really empower someone and help someone by simply focusing on financial growth if you don't empower someone personally. And you can't really help someone propel professionally unless you help them with better managing their money and so on and so forth. So what we do is we partner with women around creating personalized learning plans, creating different types of resource libraries, and helping you connect with other mentors and members so that you can get ahead and accelerate your own path towards your equality, whatever success means to you. Okay, so let's have a look at what it is that we'll be talking about today. Of course, I have promised you that we'll be talking about goals. In fact, why smart goals don't work. We'll be doing the opposite. We'll be talking about goal setting and the way in which you actually can achieve your goals. So what I'll be sharing with you is my own journey with goal setting and some successes that I've had in goal setting, but also some failures that I've had and why that has been the case. And my hope around that is that you learn from those insights and really leverage that in your own personal journey so that you don't make the same mistakes that I've done, so that you don't make the same mistakes that I've seen other people do, and so that you're able to capitalize instead on the insights, on the opportunities, and really be able to achieve your goals. We'll be talking about why goal setting is important, but it actually doesn't work on its own. There's a bit of a secret sauce to this. And we'll be talking about some practical activities. We've got a little bit of homework for you, which we'll be working on in session, that I would like you to do, that'll really help you put the tools in place to really be successful in the actions of goal achieving. So if you don't already, I would love for you to please have a pen or paper ready, pen and paper rather ready, and write as many notes as you can, but also make sure you write your homework, your to-dos, and take part as actively as you can in this session. I want you to do that, one, for yourself, so that you get the most out of the session, you can remember the notes. But two, when you take part in the session, when you're thinking, when you're in the chatbot, when you're sharing your ideas, and you're writing things down, you're using more of your whole self. When you use more of your whole self in any kind of learning activity, you are more likely to retain everything that it is that you've learned. So if you want your time to be a good investment today, if you want the time that you spent here to be not just a nice feel-good hour, not just some good company over lunch and hearing some good stuff around goal, but if you want it to actually translate into something, if you want to actually create change for yourself, then you do need to get as actively involved as possible, because you remember it, and by remembering it, you're more likely to go back to it and actually do something about it. And of course, speaking of doing something about it, we will talk to you as well about the Remarkable Woman community, because if this session is helpful for you, and I hope that it is, then what I want for you is to be able to have you continue that learning and growth journey and have that continually help you achieve whatever outcome it is that you were looking for. We've got a whole bunch of support and resources to help you make that happen through the Remarkable Woman. So I will be sharing a little bit about that today as well. Okay, so are we ready, ladies? Yes. Can I get a couple of yeses? How are you feeling about today's session? And what is it that you want to get out of this time together? I want to hear a little bit from you. So type it in the chat box if you can. How are you feeling? What is it that you want to get out of it? Are you ready? And let's get started in this goal setting session. Thank you, Marina. Love seeing your enthusiasm there. And I want to hear from more of you. So type in the chat box now. Great to hear from you, Karishma, and great to see that you are ready. And again, you're doing exactly what I've asked from you, which is get involved. And the more that you do, the more that you're going to retain. So lovely to see you leading by example. Okay, so why is goal setting so important? Well, of course, without a plan, whatever it is that we want to do is simply a dream. And dreams, unfortunately, don't come true. We wake up and poof, they're gone. If you want to make something turn into a reality, if you want that goal, if you want that dream to turn into reality, you absolutely have to set a goal. But the interesting thing is, we're actually really good at setting goals. I don't know about you, but I often will have these, you know, dreamy conversations with my girlfriends. It's either over a cup of coffee or a glass of wine. And I'll talk about, you know, what I want the year to look like, what I want my life to look like, what it is that I want to do, whether it be from a health perspective, a gym perspective, a life perspective, a work perspective, a financial perspective. I actually think we're really good at setting goals. We're really good at wanting more from ourselves. And it's so powerful because it instills hope in us. It creates a sense of motivation. It creates a feeling of a brighter tomorrow. And that will continually keep you going. It'll help you think about pathways that you need to employ in order to get there. It'll get you motivated and create some agency around you. We're quite good at that. What we're not good at is thinking about the actions that we have to undertake in order to achieve those goals. And so we're going to be talking a lot about the secret science to really cementing those actions and really as a result, achieving those goals. Has anyone here ever had a business idea? A random business idea for themselves that they want to do, or a business idea for a friend that they want to do? Can I just get a quick yes in the chat box if that's ever happened to you? Marina, D, Emma, yes. Great to hear from you. Pranita, yes. Okay. So Karishma, yeah, and great to hear from you again, Karishma. Love how active you are in the chat bot. Go you, sister. Chantel, thank you. So tell me, when you first had that idea, did it feel just so real? Did you feel like, goodness, I'm so excited about it. I can actually see this happening. The emotions were so heightened. It was right up here. You could see the dream falling into fruition. You could see all these different pathways and how awesome, this new business could be, all the different people that you could work with, maybe the different revenue that you could earn, the different stakeholders that you could tap into, the different and interesting and fun ways that you could market it, all the different products that you can, you can roll out. Did it start sort of panning out for you in your head when you had this business idea? Did you start to see that wonderful future come through? Oh, yeah, Krishma, you definitely did. Love it. Anyone else just see this so clearly in their heads as this 3D movie playing out in front of them around, okay, I've got this idea and here's exactly how it's going to happen. Great. This is so common. When we first set a goal, we get so attached to it. We really start to viscerally dream our future, or as I say, we've got this 3D movie playing in our head about how beautiful this end destination is going to be. We fall in love with the destination. We marry that destination. And we can really see that playing out. So you can see that here, right? Setting a goal, it really focuses you. It creates motivation. It brings upon energy. All of that stuff will happen. The stuff that doesn't happen is we forget to fall in love with the process. We forget to fall in love with the actions. We fall in love with the destination instead. A really good example of this is when anyone ever has a goal around losing weight. Has anyone ever had a goal around losing weight or getting fitter or getting more toned or fitting into a certain outfit or squatting a certain weight or running a certain length, certain number of kilometers? Yeah. Okay. So you've all had that. When you created that goal, did you get really attached to the outcome? You kind of saw yourself in that outfit. You saw yourself in that dress. You saw yourself in that swimwear that you were going to wear to the beach, and you really fell in love and you married the outcome. This is what I'm going to look like. Yeah. And that's what often happens. What we forget about is, in order to get there, this is what I need to do. We stop visualizing the process. And so I'm going to help you in this webinar get really good at, instead of marrying the destination, it's actually really important to marry the destination. You need to have that motivation. You need to be future focused, but also you need to marry the process. You need to marry the action. You need to fall in love with the actions. When you start falling in love with the actions, the destination will simply appear. When you stop falling in love with the actions, the destination gets further and further apart because you stop doing the actions. You start getting demotivated and we start to disconnect with the goal. And then we start to see that business idea, coming back to that business idea, 12 months down the line, 2 months down the line, you start to disconnect with it. You start to go, yeah, I had this great business idea, but you know what? Actually, I don't think that's going to work because, there are all these different things that are wrong with it because you didn't fall in love with the process and you started to get more and more divorced from the overall outcome as a result. So goal setting is important. Looking at the future outcome is important, but the actions are even more so. What else stands in our way of achieving our goals? One of the other things, if we could just go to the next slide, please. One of the other things that stands in our way is we often think, oh, when I have enough time, I will achieve those goals. And I think if anything, 2020 and 2021, people telling you that it's too hard. Ladies, can you please keep this up? Thank you, Dee, for sharing that with me. Keep telling me what's standing in your way and I'll help you unpack that. I've got a great strategy for you, Dee. On how to unpack that. If I don't answer that question for you before the end of this webinar, remind me and I'll come back to you on that. Often people will also say, I just need enough time. 2020 and 2021 has taught us that time is not the answer. We have been given so much time to work from home. We've been, our social lives have completely been taken away from us. And yet there are so many different goals that most of us didn't work on. And I've got a funny example here. We had one of the women in Team TRW saying that she needed to sort out her garage, and she went the whole of 2020 not having enough time to sort out her garage. So time isn't the problem. Motivation isn't really the problem. It's the attachment. We need to be looking at that. And what is the answer around that? The answer is we need to be setting our goals to be linked to our habits. So let's move through to the next slide. Okay, just having a read of this. The daily habits are there, but are done as a have to do rather than a want to do. Okay, we'll address that for you, Deanna. Thank you for sharing. So let's look at some goals that did work for me and goals that didn't work for me. And I want you to do some reflection and see if some of this is marrying out in playing out in your life. And if it is, what you might change as a result of insights that have been the ones where I have aligned those to my sense of purpose, to my sense of values, my identity, my morals, and things that can fit into my routine, my habits, and things that feel good. Goals that haven't worked for me are the ones that I have done for everyone else. And I'll give you an example of this. I've grown up in a strong Indian community. And one of the things that I've really had to butt heads on is this overall societal expectation that Indian girls need to play nice. And you know what? This is something that plays out to women universally as well. I don't really think this is just an Indian community thing, but this is my experience within my community. We need to play nice. We need to play small. We need to be really good domestically. I was socialized to be seen but not heard. And part of me bought into that a little bit. Because you want to impress everyone, you want people to like you, you want to be accepted by society, and so I really tried to do those things. I tried to be this domestic goddess. I tried to wake up early and do all of this house stuff, and then get onto the workday. And I mean, first off, domestic stuff isn't fun for anyone. Some people enjoy it. I just don't. But I wasn't doing it for me. I was doing it for others. I was doing it to impress the community, to be the good Indian girl. And as a result, it wasn't sustainable. I didn't feel good about it. I hated myself, and I ended up resenting other people. And of course, I failed miserably at this goal, which was I'm going to leave the house every day. And when I leave the house, my house is going to be in order. It wasn't something that I was doing for me. It was something that I was doing for others. And so as a result, I failed miserably. It happened to a girlfriend of mine as well, and I'll never forget the really harrowing experience that she went through, because she was setting her goals for other people. Her situation was she was setting her goals to make her mother happy. And as everyone, I'm sure everyone remembers, because it was such a stressful period, and it's happening now for any of you who've got children and children who are in year 12 and doing their HSC right now. It's a very topical example. For her, she was doing her HSC and getting her HSC results for her mother. And so as a result, her mother really wanted to see her be really successful in subjects such as biology and physics. And so she enrolled in biology and physics for year 11 and 12. And she was busting her chops, trying to do everything she could to be really successful in those two subjects. And as a result, get a really good HSC mark. You can kind of guess what happened, right? She was absolutely miserable. She was working twice as hard to just pass, to just be average, because she wasn't working in an area of strength, and she wasn't working in an area where she was genuinely motivated, and she wasn't doing it for herself. She was doing it for someone else. So she was spending twice as long studying, and unfortunately didn't get the outcome that she wanted, wasn't able to fulfill her goals of, I want to go to university and I want to do this course, because she wasn't aligning herself to where it is that she really should have been spending time, when really she was this incredible networker and someone that should have been doing, different subjects altogether. And you're going to find stuff like this will play out for you time and time again when you set goals that are there to impress society, family, and other people. When it's there and it's driven by others. It's also what you'll find is when you're setting goals that are maybe driven by money, driven by outcome, and maybe you're not driven by money. So how do you know what it is that you're driven by? There's a really good survey that we've got at The Remarkable Woman that I'll work through with you. Can I just ask here, just to get a feel from the group, does everyone know what it is that they're really motivated by? If they're motivated by, achieving things, if they're motivated by supporting people, if they're motivated by power, and how to make those things really, as a result, align for themselves by being the best director and producer of their own lives. Is this something that you were clear on? Can I just get a yay or a nay? Okay. Brilliant. So it seems, Pranita Chantel, you're clear on what it is that you're motivated by. That is wonderful. For those of you who are a bit unclear on what it is that you're motivated by, we're going to show you a quick survey that you can actually do that'll really help you enable some clarity around, where is it that I should be setting my goals? And how should I be supporting myself to be super successful? There's a great motivational survey called the Human Motivational Survey. And that'll help you really unpack whether or not you were motivated by achievement, whether or not you're motivated by affiliation, or whether or not you're motivated by power. What we're taking you into is the Remarkable Hub. And this is where all members can go to at any time and take any one of these self-awareness surveys so that you are the best director and producer of your own life. And as a result, you're better able to set goals for yourself with absolute clarity. Here is the human motivation survey. And for those of you who didn't answer with yes and perhaps need a little bit of help on getting clear on that, you're able to then find out, okay, this is what I'm motivated by. And so as a result, here is how I'm going to set some goals. So if you're motivated by power, you probably want to set a goal that is really big picture and will help you achieve some kind of significance or status in life. If you were motivated by achievement, you want to make sure that you've got some rewards for you along the way. If you're motivated by affiliation, you want to make sure that the goals that you're setting really speak to your values, and that is by supporting other people, I'm supporting myself. I fill my cup by filling other people's cups. So knowing thyself will also help you be really successful at achieving your goals, not just setting your goals. All right, so let's go back into the presentation. Wonderful. Okay. So now let's move into how we actually get you to achieve your goals by first off being clear on what stops people from achieving their goals. The first one is just our human condition. Now, I don't know about you, but most of us will actually do things that feel good to us, do things that feel comfortable to us. We've all heard this saying, growth comes from being uncomfortable. Now, why do we hear this saying time and time again? It's because it has to be badgered into us, right? We need to be pushed into discomfort in order to grow, in order to be the best versions of ourselves. We are simply not going to grow by sitting on the couch and watching Netflix as much as we'd like to do so. We're not going to get any growth out of that. But really, our human condition is wired to stay in the comfortable, because that's where things feel safe. That's where things feel happy. We know exactly what's going to happen. And so that's why we tend to play small. We tend to stay in the realm of our current work. And if you're thinking about, you know, an example of this, it might be, you know, am I, when I'm at work, am I going to put my hand up and give that suggestion? Or am I not going to do that because maybe I'm going to look silly, or maybe I'm going to put myself in a position where I'm saying something that isn't going to be accepted by the group, or I'm creating additional work for myself that I might not be able to do with as much confidence. And so by doing that, by second guessing ourselves, we tend not to actually put our hands up and make ourselves uncomfortable. So instead, we stay with the comfort. So one of the biggest reasons why we won't achieve our goals is because we start to ask ourselves, do I want to do that? Do I feel like doing that? So if your goal is, I want to get up every morning and I want to go on a 5K run, right? You will inevitably start doing this really funny monologue with yourself where you'll wake up in the morning or your alarm will go off and you will ask yourself, hey, Shivani, do I feel like getting out of bed? The answer is going to be, of course not. You don't feel like getting out of bed. You want to stay in bed. You want to continue being where it's comfortable. You getting out of bed is where you are uncomfortable. Staying in bed, staying where we are, keeps us comfortable. You finally get out of bed and the house is nice and warm and cozy. And then you say to yourself, do I feel like getting out there and going for a run? Maybe it's a little bit chilly outside. No, of course you don't feel like doing that. Of course you don't feel like jumping out and getting out of your pajamas and getting out of the house. All of that is discomfort. So the secret to achieving your goals is to not ask yourself, do I feel like doing something? Because it triggers the feeling of discomfort. So in short, don't think, don't ask yourself, just do. And a great way to do that is to circumnavigate any of these questions. So you're putting the alarm on the other side of the room. You're not asking yourself, do I feel like getting out of bed? You have to get out of bed in order to take away the discomfort of that really loud alarm. And once you get there, once you arrive at that destination where your alarm is, your gym clothes are already there. It's there. You don't have to ask yourself, do I feel like getting into these clothes? And therefore having to get to my wardrobe and actually, you know, getting myself into my gym gear and going for a run, it's there and you're going to do it. That is the first step to stopping yourself from not achieving these goals. Okay. The second thing is where an expert at coming up with excuses. So who here has set a goal And in 12 months' time, you've spoken to a friend, and a friend's gone, oh, you know, how's that business idea going? And you're like, oh, look, I've decided to move away from that. You know, I've thought about it, and it's just not going to work. It's not going to work. Experts at making excuses. And the reason why we do that is because we don't want to feel bad about it. We don't want to feel guilty and making ourselves feel terrible to go, hang on, I set this goal for myself and now I'm not doing it. So we're really good at instead talking ourselves out of the goal and making ourselves feel really good about talking ourselves out of the goal so we can justify our own actions. Time and time again, I'll hear people say, I really want to become the best version of myself. I want to invest in myself. I want to get that leadership position. I want to move into my boss's role. Then I want to move into my boss's role. And to do that, I know I've got to do this course. Or to do that, I know that I've got to invest in public speaking. And so I've probably got to go and do a 20-minute talk in public or something like that. Or I've probably got to take on a leadership course. And then as you get closer and closer to actually doing that, you start to go, yeah, you know what? The timing's just not right. I'm moving houses right now. So things really aren't in a good place, but next year will be a much better time. You will start to justify your actions. You will start to create excuses that make so much sense to you, and you become really good at selling that to others. And so by doing so, you're actually talking yourself out of it. So again, you need to find a way to not create excuses for yourself and simply do anyway. Does that resonate with anyone? Has anyone ever set some really good excuses for themselves around moving houses? You know, work is simply too busy. I'm simply not getting enough time at the moment. Okay. So there are some things that you can do around it. The third is we start, but we don't sustain action. So this is another time bound one. If you feel like you are, you're strapped to time, and you're not getting your goals done, what I want you to do instead is do a little mind hack around just getting started, and I'll take you through that in a different slide because we've actually got some more information on that. The fourth one is we'll do the easy stuff first. So when you start your workday, most people will start with their emails or start with responding to other people as opposed to really working on their own priorities. Another big reason why people don't achieve their goals. And the fifth is we start to see ourselves as procrastinators because we've opted out of our goals so many times, we've created so many excuses, we start to see that for ourselves. And as a result, it becomes self-limiting. But that is a learned behavior, which you can unlearn by taking the action. All right, let's move forward. Okay, so what do you need to do in order to be one of the 8% of people that actually achieve their goals? So we talked about the destination. We talked about romanticizing the destination, beginning with the end in mind, which is great. What you now need to do is you now need to build a support system. You need to find all the people that are actually going to help you achieve those goals, and you need to tell them about it. You need to help them to keep you accountable. You need to set specific goals along the way, so mini challenges along the way. So if health is one of them, if losing weight is one of them, if running, 5Ks is one of them, you need to have mini goals along the way, which is I'm just going to run 500 meters on this day. By day five, I'm going to get to a kilometer, and so on and so forth. You need to have mini check-ins with yourself. Recognize when you're procrastinating. Have little alarms that are set to break you out of cycles. Practice the 52 and 17 rule. This is some great evidence around this that is actually scientifically backed. You need to turn off all distractions for 52 minutes and simply do deep work. Tell yourself that is all you're going to do. Once you do that, give yourself a 17-minute break and don't work at all. Don't do anything. Don't answer an email. Don't quickly respond to a Slack message. Don't jump into Teams. Go for a walk. Call a friend. Have a meal. Completely switch off. Because by completely switching off, you're rejuvenating your brain. And by doing so, you're giving yourself more power to sustain the action that will therefore achieve your goals. Listen to music or do something that you can to help you focus, and do not multitask. As women, we're set up for failure on this because we're constantly told that we're great multitaskers. So ladies, stop being a great multitasker. Be someone who simply focuses on one thing at a time and you will be more productive. Okay, let's move forward. So here is a little bit of homework for you. For all of you who are here live, I'm actually going to send this slide to you because this is some stuff that I want you to do on your own. And that is figuring out what your sense of purpose is, and as a result of that, what values align with that, and so therefore what your goals should be, so that your goals really matter to you. They don't matter to someone else, they matter to you, and you are going to be invested in actually achieving them. I'm going to show you one of the videos that I'd like you to watch inside the Remarkable Hub for those of you who are members, and for those of you who aren't, we will certainly welcome you to becoming a member and actually going through this video training. Let's bring up the Find Your Why video training. So here is a great video that you can watch within 15 minutes or less. And for those of you who don't know what your sense of purpose is, what your sense of why is, I'll take you through an exercise that you can actually do by going deep into your childhood and figuring out some of the best memories that you've had and what's really driven you as a child, some of your most compelling life experiences, the good and the bad, what that's taught you, how that's shaped you, and where it is that you want to go. And as a result of that, what is your purpose and your why statement? My why statement is to be fearless in the pursuit of a greater tomorrow with courage and compassion. Show up in that. Every single goal that I set has to check off that. Am I being fearless in my pursuit of greater tomorrow? Is that goal bold enough? And if it isn't, am I really playing to my strengths? That will help you consistently stay on track with the way in which you set goals and to always ensure that it's something that is relevant to you. So that's some homework that we're going to send out to you at the end of this webinar. Okay, so now let's move on to, instead of setting goals from a SMART perspective, what you should be doing instead. So everyone here probably knows the SMART goal setting framework. Your goals need to be specific, measurable, you need to be accountable, they need to be realistic, and they need to be time bound. There's a key element to this that means that SMART goals simply don't work. The key element is what's missing is actions. There is no focus on your actions. And so as I was saying to you earlier, most people will fall in love with the overall destination. This is what I'm going to look like when I achieve those goals, when I become that leader, when I set up that incredible business and so therefore have time on my hands and I can, you know, wake up in the morning and go to a cafe and have breakfast and have a coffee and set my own working hours and so forth. You fall in love with that destination, but not the actions that you need to employ in order to get you there. So what do you need to do in order to create a new framework to do that? I'd like to introduce the CoStar method. The CoStar method works like this. The first thing that I want you to do when you're setting a goal is to review where it is that you are today. So that creates a great benchmark to where it is that you are today versus where you want to be. So you can see the gap there. If it is, I want to move into a leadership position. Okay, what role do you currently have? And what is the gap between that and the leadership position? So where are you currently? The second one is the goal. What is your objective? What is it that you want to do? So if in this example, you wanted to get more sleep and you're only getting 6 hours a night, your objective is 8 hours a night, now we start moving into the actions. And the actions happen via strategies and tactics. The overall strategy might be, okay, I need to free up 2 hours of my evening in order to create an 8 hour block of sleep. So what are the short-term quick fixes that I can do? What are the tactics that I can employ in order to get there? So some examples around this are, I might finish my day around 6 o'clock so that I can start winding down by 9:30. Who are you going to tap on the shoulder to help you keep yourself accountable? And how often are you going to review your progress so that you can go back to current objectives and keep moving forward so that you can keep re-looping your progress towards achieving your goal? There's one more step to this, and that is creating habits in order to achieve your goals and to really marry that to your CoStar style of achieving goals. And that is habit stacking. So you've already got a habit every night. If we were to continue on with this this example, I have a goal of wanting to get 8 hours sleep. For me, my habit every night is brushing my teeth. I will brush my teeth before I go to bed. So that is a cue. I brush my teeth. When I brush my teeth, I get into my pajamas. And when I get into my pajamas, I go to bed. So the great thing for you to do around being really sustainable and successful in achieving your goals is to stack one action on top of another. So if I am brushing my teeth already and I'm doing it at 9:30, why didn't I bring that cue earlier? Why didn't I bring that to 9 p.m. so that I'm getting into my pajamas earlier, so that I'm unwinding earlier? Habit stacking helps you because you've already got something that is already ingrained in you. It might be the other way around. It might be that you want to go for a run every morning, but you're simply just not getting out of the house. So you're going to stack one habit on top of the other. You brush your teeth in the morning, and what you're going to do is you're going to stack on top of that getting into your gym gear so that you can get out of the house. So it's an if then. If I brush my teeth in the morning, then I'm going to get into my gym clothes and I'm going to go. By doing that and stacking additional things on top of each other, you're creating a momentum for success. We've got some great video training on giving you a step-by-step process on how to do this called habit stacking in the Remarkable Hub. And this is so important for you to do because 40% of everything that you do in life is habits. So imagine if you can turn those habits into goals. Imagine if you can set a goal and your goal is simply a habit and that translates into success for you. So that is what I want you to get really good at doing. There's some more homework for you on this. And what I want you to do is think about what habit stack you might create for yourself. I want you to choose one area of your life, whether it be a lifestyle habit, a work habit, or a learning habit. Then I want you to think about a goal that is aligned to your values and your sense of purpose that you want to set for yourself in order to be really successful around that goal. And now I want you to write 5 small steps that you'll employ in order to achieve that. I'd love to hear how you go with this. So we're going to check in with you via email post this webinar, and we'd love to see what your 5 small steps are. So again, a little bit more homework to help you stay accountable. Okay, let's move forward. Okay, more things that will stand in your way to achieving your goals. If there's any perfectionists in the room, I know that I certainly am. Most of us will tend to actually stop doing something because we want it to be perfect. And by wanting it to be perfect, not only do we take twice as long, sometimes 3 times as long in order to do that one thing, sometimes we don't even start because we feel like we don't have the amount of time that we need in order to create this wonderful piece of work. My advice for you there is to not let perfect get in the way of progress. Simply think about how much progress can I make in 10 minutes? Start. And I would set a timer around it. So set yourself a timer of 10 minutes and do as much as you can in 10 minutes. It's a wonderful mindset hack. And what you're going to find is that once we start doing something, it doesn't feel good to stop. You're already there. And once you start doing it, you're going to just keep on going. You may find that your 10-minute alarm goes off and you go, I'm going to carry on now because now I'm starting to feel good. Now I'm starting to make some progress. Progress will create momentum and the momentum will create further motivation for you to keep going. So here's a great slide or a hack around this. Instead of I don't have any time, I'm going to get started and do as much as I possibly can. Instead of this is going to take me forever, I am simply going to get started in 10 minutes. Try that as a mindset hack and see how you go. The other that I employ is a be to come, and that is in order to be something, we need to do the actions in order to become that. So let's become future focused. If I want to be an entrepreneur, if I want to be a leader of my organization or whatever it is, I must do these actions. You need to step into the shoes of that person and sustain those actions in order to become it. So what I want you to do is to think about, okay, if I want to be the CEO of a multi-million-dollar business, what are the actions that a CEO of a multi-million-dollar business will employ? Well, they're probably going to have a really strong morning routine. They are probably going to have a really strong business plan. They're probably going to review that business plan on a regular basis. They're going to surround themselves with people who can give them great advice. So they're going to go out and seek that advice. They're going to have strong accountability partners. So I'm going to go out and do all of those things because that is what I want to be. And by doing all of those things, I'm going to become that CEO of a multi-million dollar business. So being future focused, being self-aware on where your strengths lie and who it is that you need to employ, which accountability partners you need to tap on the shoulder in order to get the support that you need in order to get there so that you can become that person. Empowerment requires us to grow up by simply doing the actions that we need to do. But how do we do those actions? You stack it onto pre-existing habits and you make sure that those habits are already something that exists for you. So that's really easy for you to go and do that. You are setting yourself up for success. Okay, so now let's move on to the questions that some of you had. I'm going to read two of the questions that I've got in here, and I'd like for you to come in and let me know what other questions that you've got. Okay, so Dee, you mentioned people telling you that it is too hard to do. So is that for you when you set a goal and other people are effectively de-incentivizing you? You're getting disenchanted, I'm assuming, by people saying, you know, it's simply too hard. Is that right? Is that how you're feeling?
Yeah, it was more about when you were talking about your big business ideas. And then you tell someone about it and then they're like, that's just going to be too hard to do. So you go, I'll move on to the next one sort of thing.
Right. Right. The first thing that I want to say to you, that, and this is a bit more of business advice, and we might actually turn the presentation off and that way I can see the forum of all the women who are in the webinar. And great to meet you, Dean. The first thing that I want to say to you is around that people will only love and support you to the extent that they've loved their own ideas, supported their own ideas, and employed the action that they needed in order to get there. And most people will lack the motivation, lack the agency, and lack the foresight around, I need to do all of these actions in order to get there. Because they are so disenchanted with their own lives and their own ability to achieve those things, they become naysayers for themselves, they become naysayers for you, right? And this happens in business time and time again as well, where you're going to find someone's either going to say, oh, that's just far too hard, or they're going to say, oh, there's like 50 businesses out there like that. Have you heard of this business? Have you heard of that business? They're doing it. They're doing it. They're doing it. No one, absolutely no one is going to do it the way that you do it. And how do you get clear on the D difference? You get clear on that by knowing thyself. You get clear on that by knowing what is the magic that you bring into it. What sets you apart? This is why knowing who you are is really important. What you're motivated by is really important. The magic that you can bring to it is really important, right? And a great example I'll give about this is recipe books, right? There are so many recipe books out there and there are so many recipes that you can Google, yet we still go out and buy these recipe books because we are getting wedded to someone and their style. There will always be an opportunity for you to go and do that. You simply need to go and find the way to make that happen. So advice number one, step out of naysayers anyway. Advice number two, if it's going to be hard, give it a crack because you are going to feel far more motivated and far more confident in yourself and you'll become a stronger backer of yourself by simply doing the hard things, by simply doing the actions. So just get started. Figure out, okay, if I want to go set up that business, there are probably three things I need to do going forward. And the first one is always, right, having a business plan or getting really clear on the business problem. And so you need to create time to do that. So your first thing is going to be stacking that onto a habit. So what is a habit you've already got? Your first thing that you do might be brushing your teeth. As soon as I brush my teeth, I always make myself a coffee. So as soon as I make my coffee and I've got one right here, I'm going to sit down on my kitchen benchtop and I'm going to spend half an hour writing. You're going to stack it to a habit. And that's how you're going to start doing the actions, which will give you the answers to rebut the naysayers. So I hope that helps. Great. Okay, back to questions. I am going into the chat bot. Okay, daily habits are there, but a done is I have to do rather than I really want to do. Okay, so what's so important around these daily habits? And if we can just go back to the screen of seeing all the participants, that'd be great because right now I can just see myself and myself. the thing around what I'd like you to do around things not feeling good is to have a reward for yourself at the end of the day. So this is why it's so important to know what you're motivated by. Are you motivated by power? If you're motivated by power, you're going to want some recognition. Ladies, there's nothing wrong with being motivated by power, and nothing to be ashamed of. You need to know that so that you can motivate yourself. If it's an achievement thing and you know that you're motivated by achievement and these habits are have to do's, well, then give yourself something at the end of the day. It might be that if I can do these things, then at the end of it, I'm going to get to a stage where I can actually sit on the couch for half an hour and indulge and have a glass of wine and watch my favorite show or whatever that is, but give yourself a reward at the end of it. And so that way the habits don't feel like, oh, this is something that I must do. The reward is really, really important. It's like when we have sugar, we get a cue, we get a craving. We have the sugar and we instantly feel the dopamine uplift. It's up to you to give yourself that dopamine by setting yourself up for success. Ladies, what I want to do now is I want to also set you up for success. We've talked about a number of things that are really going to help you achieve your goals. But as you can see, I've only skimmed the surface. There is so much that I can take you through. And I've taken you through some really big topics in really quick spurts, you know, a little bit about habits, a little bit about goals, a little bit about how you can set your mindset up for success and a little bit of advice around, how you can set up a business for yourself. I can't possibly do all of this and go deep dive into this for you in 45 minutes. But what I want to do is I want to partner with you to really change your life around this. And so what I really invite you to do is to come on board the Remarkable Woman community so that I can support you by partnering you with mentors around any specific questions that you've got around setting up that business, around getting that leadership position, around, you know, cementing that habit and making it feel good, but also around, you know, getting you access to masterclass videos to help you really upskill. So the membership looks a little bit like this. If we could actually go into the portal, that'd be wonderful. And I'll show you what it actually involves to give you a little bit of a sneak peek. If you were to come into the membership, the kind of support you will actually get. So for those of you who are Remarkable Woman members, you would already see this. For those of you who aren't, you'll see that when you become a member, you have your very own dashboard. And the place that most women start is by actually tapping into mentors. So by actually going into Mentor Connect, you are able to connect with any one of our mentors that'll really help you by sharing their own life insights, their own wisdom and journey to give you the kind of advice that I've been giving you today and getting that one-on-one support. So by you listing what your goals are, you'll be able to get two mentoring sessions a month. And we will pair you with mentors. As you can see here, I've got two suggested mentors based on what my goals are. This is my profile. But you can also click on View More Mentors and you can connect with any one of our mentors and have two mentoring sessions a month as part of your membership with us. And this is one of the most powerful things you can do because you're expanding your network of experts. Okay, let's go back into the dashboard. The other thing is I talked so much about knowing thyself, right? There are going to be so many naysayers in your life that are really going to, make you feel kind of crappy about the goals that you want to set. I want you to tap out of those people and I want you to tap into people who really support you instead. So if we go into surveys, one of the first things that I want you to do is to know yourself by understanding what really drives you. So there's a great self-awareness survey that you can do here that is a bit of a reflection journey that will help you get yourself into a time and structure of understanding, you know, how can you better care for yourself? How can you better motivate yourself? How can you be more successful from a career, from a business, from a finance perspective? If we were to scroll down, there is there is another great survey here that is around your personal brand. So knowing the value that you add, what people say about you when you leave the room, does that brand really serve you? What is your superpower? What is your leadership style? What do people get out of spending time with you? And as a result, what businesses you might be able to set up as a result or what leadership style you might want to employ as a result. Then we move into different video masterclasses. Now, I talked about the power of habit stacking, and I've only really been able to do so over 5 minutes because there is so much that I want to share with you. But what you're able to do is you're able to deep dive into specific webinars here and be able to understand different things around different pillars, personal, professional, and financial, whether it be, being a better manager of your own finances, whether it be how to present and communicate to maximum impact. I think, Dee, this one is for you. We were talking around, different business models and the different kind of business plans you might want to set up. I've got a great video training on how to think like an entrepreneur as well. And so if we were to click on that, what you'll also find is not only will you have a bit of video training, but you've also got some related resources like a startup Kickstarter cheat sheet. Can we just open that up? Because this has got all of my secret sauce on how I have started up my two startups. So you'll see here, I've created a bit of a strategy paper for you. If we were to just click on page 2 and page 3, that'd be great. So there's some great questions here, helping you unpack what your problem statement might be. So who it is that you're serving. If we were to click on the next page, you'll see that we'll talk to you about, creating a value statement. Then we'll help you figure out what your hypothesis might be and then really building that forward. This is the secret sauce to how I have built my startup and how I advise other people to do so. Now, for those of you who are leading organizations, people who are just simply leading yourselves, you should use this for your own corporations. I've actually created this. I actually used a similar model when I was I was back in corporate world, and the feedback that I got from one of the CEOs that I was presenting this to was, I love this so much that I keep it on my top right hand drawer, and I pull it out from time to time to think about strategies that you've implemented. So if you're thinking about, well, how do I get my next promotion? How do I get noticed? You employ business strategies like this that have some really strong rigor to it. You can't know all of this stuff off the top of your head. You need to have support from people like myself and other mentors in order to get there. And so this is why we've created a platform for you to be able to tap into different, different cheat sheets, different resources, different videos in order to do so. Does anyone here also have some financial goals? Is anyone here looking to save a little bit of money or be better at managing their budgets? Can I just get a quick idea of what that might be in the chat bot, please? I just want to make sure that what I'm talking about is relevant to you. Okay, saving for a house. All right, so let's go to money calculators. We've also got some great things that will help you be, better directors and producers of your own life, and also making sure that you're not tapping into people, for advice that simply just don't know what they're talking about. In my time as a financial advisor, I cannot tell you how frustrated I used to get for people because they used to miss out on opportunities because they were speaking to their friends and neighbors and so forth around validating some of their finance ideas for themselves, as opposed to going to, genuine sources of truth. I want you instead to go to genuine sources of truth so that you are able to achieve the financial goals that you have. So for those of you who don't have a budget, we've got a great budget planner here. Now this is a bit like your financial journal. All of this is purely confidential, ladies. You'll put in your take-home pay. You can even put in your desired take-home pay as well and figure out what you might get after tax as a result of that and what might go into HEX and all of that sort of stuff as well. You'll be able to put in your current expenses or your proposed expenses and see what you've got as a result left over. If you're saving for a house, you'll be able to go into our home loan calculator and think about and get clarity on, well, if I want to buy a home and my home loan is going to be $500,000, how much interest am I going to be paying? What are my monthly repayments going to be? And as a result, can I really afford that? So what I've really done for you is I have fused in all of my life knowledge from financial services, from leading people, teams, and startups, and created a community of mentors, video masterclasses, tools, and resources in order to help you accelerate your path to success. So as a result of that, here is my invitation to you. I would love for as many of you to sample what our community and what our support looks like for you. And so my team have organized a 7-day free trial for all of you to jump on board. My team will have the link in the chat box for you and to just jump on board. and have a look at what the membership looks like for you. You know, what a learning plan would look like for you. So your onboarding experience will be like this. You'll come on board for a 7-day free trial. We will partner with you and find out what your specific goals are. Remember this. And as a result of that, we will set up a learning plan for you to say, okay, well, here are the actions you need to take. If your goal is you want to set up your own business, but at the same time, you're struggling with a bit of imposter syndrome, a bit of lack of self-doubt, maybe you don't know where it is that you're going. I had a mentoring session yesterday where a woman said to me, you know, I'm 40 years old, Shivani, and I still don't know what I want to do when I grow up. I've kind of felt fallen into my career and I just kind of keep doing the same stuff. You know, we will, as a result, her learning plan is we've got a career map for her. We've got a video training that we've matched her up with that helps her really get really good insights and clarity around the kind of career that she should plan for herself. And as a result, what kind of career map she should have. So we'll ask you some really valid questions around what your goals are, what your challenges are. We will create a learning plan for you off the back of that. So that, and for those of you who are paying a lot of attention at the beginning of the webinar, you'll know what I'm going to say, so that you can take the actions that you need in order to be really successful in achieving your goals. So that you can, you know, watch the habit stacking video, for example, and understand, okay, in order for me to be really successful in achieving my goals, I want to be one of those 8% of people that's going to be successful in achieving the goals. I'm going to stack it to a habit. So I need to know what the cue is for the habit. The cue might be I wake up in the morning. And so I'm going to stack something on top of that. And as a result, I'm always going to be successful because it is simply a habit for me. So ladies, I would love for you to join the community. So the offer is there for yours for the taking. If you would like to join us, you are more than welcome to do so over the next 24 hours, and you can capitalize on a free trial for 7 days and help us help you. So that is all the time that we have for you today. Before I leave you, has this session been helpful? Is there anything else that you might like to follow up on? Leave a comment in the chat bot and we will follow up with you to do our best to support you in your learning and growth journey, and importantly, in achieving your goals. Thank you, Dee. As are you, and so lovely to work with you and have you. Would love to work with you in the community as well. Ladies, it's been such an absolute pleasure to spend this hour with you. I hope to see all of you. And I look forward to you in a chance being your very best versions of yourselves. Until next time.